This episode of Around the Oval is brought to you by Todd Pennington with Revolution Mortgage.
Hey, Ohio State fans. Alex Gleitman from BuckeyeScoop.com here, back with another edition of Around the Oval presented by Todd Pennington with Revolution Mortgage. Today, we have a very special guest with us all the way from Olathe, Kansas. We have 2022 prospect Ohio State offer. Some people think he's a safety. Some people think he's a linebacker. I like to say he's just a great athlete. Dasan McCullough. Dasan, thanks for joining the show today. How are you and your family doing?
Thank you for having me. We're doing all good. How are you?
I'm good. Thanks. You know, I think everyone's hanging in the best we can be given the circumstances. Hopefully, you know, things get better in the country soon, but I appreciate you being on the show. I know you're one of Ohio State's top priority targets for the 2022 class, which they've been spending a lot of work on. You know, hopefully they're able to get out and see you play some high school football this year. We'll see what happens. But with that in mind, like, tell us a little bit about, you know, I know what's going on. I'm from New Jersey, so I know what's going on here in New York City. I know what's going on in Ohio. Everywhere is different, though, with, you know, the upcoming football season. What's going on in Kansas?
Just yesterday, they cleared us that we're going to have a season. It's going to start about a week later, though, but everything's still on time. I know some schools and some districts around here, they took 2 weeks off to kind of quarantine their kids before they come back. But as of having the season, we're definitely having one this fall that got cleared here recently.
That's awesome to hear. What have you guys been doing, you know, your team, Blue Valley North, as far as, you know, being able to prep for the upcoming season? Have you been able to have, like, workouts with your teammates? Have you been able to do – I know in New Jersey, like, just I think it was Monday, they were able to have their first, like, organized team workouts, no pads or anything. But what have you guys been able to do?
Yeah, so since June 15th, we've been having a team organized workouts, all outdoor workouts, nothing allowed in the weight room yet. But we've been having all outdoor workouts, and just here this past week, we started getting into more football activities, like 7-on-7 and more review and stuff like that. So, I mean, for the most part, it's kind of our normal summer routine, but the only difference would be around this time, we're supposed to be getting the helmets and pads on.
Yeah, no, I hear you. What are you playing for your high school team? What positions?
I play free safety, middle linebacker, and kind of like a hybrid middle safety. It's kind of all over the place.
Kind of like a little Isaiah Simmons action. Move you around a little bit, let you make some plays.
Yeah, definitely. They move me around a lot of different spots. It's going to depend on who we play and personnel and all those things. But I'm all over the place, kind of learning everything.
Nice. And what's your height and weight right now?
I'm 6'5", 220 right now.
Man, that's incredible. And so I guess with that in mind, you know, we'll talk a little bit about your college recruiting. I know we were just talking off air about the background. Everyone could see you have what? I know you have over 40 offers. How many offers do you have right now?
I have 42, I think, right now.
42, yeah. It was 41 last I checked, so 42. It seems like you get another one every day probably. But it's pretty cool setup you got there with all the different pennants of the different schools you got. We don't see Ohio State back there, but I'm sure it's
– Yeah, it's right back there. It's literally right off camera.
Yeah, no, cool. But, you know, 41 offers, like 42 offers, it's incredible as a junior. How does it feel to be so wanted this early in the process?
It feels good just because you know your value, basically. You know, I learned my value, I think, in the middle of last year. I realized that I'm actually real versatile and I can play a lot of different positions at a high level. So, you know, having all these offers just kind of reminds me the expectations these teams have you that you know, they set the bar with what they think you can be and what you could work to be. So just kind of taking it as motivation for the most part. That's how I kind of look at it.
Yeah, for sure. And, you know, we talked about your position a little bit, what you play in high school. Obviously, 6'5", 220, you're going to get even bigger when you get into a college weight program. Are most schools talking to you about linebacker, or where do most schools see you kind of penciling in?
It really depends. I'd say most of the schools I released in my top 10 are looking at me as a linebacker. There are a couple schools who look at me as kind of a strong safety, move around type guy like that too. So, I mean, it kind of just depends on the scheme of the college you're talking about. But it's everywhere, but I'd say the majority would probably be based off of an outside linebacker.
Yeah. Do you have a preference of where you play or?
No, I don't really care where I play. It could be anywhere. It's really just wherever I can get on the field the earliest and then, you know, show my athletic ability would be fine for me.
No doubt. And, you know, 42 schools. I mean, you technically don't really have to make a decision until at the earliest next December, the early signing period. Then the latest, I guess, would be the February signing period in February 2022. But have you thought, like, is there any school standing out right now for you?
You know, my whole top 10, I could say, is standing out. And when you talk about me committing, I plan to commit before my senior year. So before this summer or this summer, you know, coming up, like this next one around. So within the next year, I plan on committing. But no, every school, I mean, recently Clemson's been recruiting me really hard. Obviously Ohio State, Michigan, LSU, and Nebraska, those have kind of just been schools, you know, here recently, but they've all been reaching out a lot.
Yeah, for sure. And I want to talk about Ohio State. I know that they've been in constant communication. I know your dad played for Miami, Ohio, and he coached there. Did you live in Ohio at all? I think you did, right?
Yes, I was born in Cincinnati, and I lived there for about 9 years. So, yeah, I was raised there.
So almost a little bit more than half your life, I guess, you mm-hmm. were born and raised. Did you grow up rooting for the Buckeyes?
No, I grew up more of a, you know, probably Miami of Ohio, you could say. Right. You know, I was just young, so I didn't really get it. I probably didn't really get the whole fan thing until I moved to Indiana. And then I was kind of – I've always been a Big Ten kid, though. I've always grew up around that and loving all those schools. So,
yeah, definitely. You obviously, you know, you grew up in Ohio. As you said, you grew up in the Midwest a lot, too. You know, just being around Ohio State kind of your whole life through that experience, you know, how do you – like, is that big for them to be able to have that base where, like, you know what they're all about and you know the type of football that's played in that conference?
You know, I think they know, since my dad's also a coach, and, you know, I've been around this for a while and I've kind of seen it work too. I think they know that I kind of just, you know, I've been around it for so long. I kind of know how it operates too. I kind of know, you know, like how business works around there and stuff like that. So when I'm talking to them, it's more of an honest conversation then, since we both kind of know what, you know, what we're trying to get out of it and what we're looking for in a school and everything like that. But it's definitely an advantage that, you know, that they use and that they can see, you know, me being from Ohio and kind of growing up, seeing that team and everything like that, seeing them play. So I can see that definitely.
Yeah. And then, I mean, the other kind of factor here is Kevin Wilson, you know, was the head coach at Indiana. Your dad coached under him. I'm sure you got to spend a lot of time with him. Is he kind of taking on that lead recruiting role for you for the Buckeyes?
No, I'd actually say Coach Washington would definitely be taking on recruiting me the most. I am staying in contact with Coach Wilson, though, just to catch up and everything like that. You know, he's not getting too involved. You know, my position coach and, you know, Coach Combs and everyone like that is really who I'm talking to. But having someone like Coach Wilson on staff is a great thing, too, just because, you know, I've been around him since I was 11. You know, I grew up around him and his family also, so. You know, that's definitely an advantage knowing that there's someone on that staff, you know, you're already close with.
Yeah, you mentioned, obviously the relationship is strong with Coach Wilson, but you mentioned Coach Washington, linebackers coach, obviously, Coach Combs, defensive coordinator, secondary coach. Talk to me a little bit about what's your relationship like with those guys?
My relationship with Coach Washington, I'd say, is very strong. You know, me and him get along, kind of have the exact same idea of what you think I could do at the next level. And, you know, me and him, we've turned on some tape. We've looked at some film, even my film, you know, just so he could help me out right now to get ready for college. And it's been great. You know, we've been in contact since, I don't know, it's been a couple months now, but I feel like I know him better than I know coaches that I've already been around in person, you know. So him, Coach Combs, me and him have a great relationship too. I stay in a lot of contact with him. Me and him are going to watch some film soon once he gets all free. And, you know, he's a great dude, real family guy. And, you know, both two real good dudes I can see myself playing for one day.
Yeah, no doubt. Have you been to Ohio State for a visit yet?
No, I've never been there. I've been there. Last time I was there was probably when I was like, probably like 12 or 13, something like that.
Yeah, so I'm sure that's pretty important for you once things open up to get out to Columbus, see what it's all about, get with the coaches in person. Is that something that you're planning on doing?
Yeah, definitely. So with all the schools in my top 10, I plan on visiting like accordingly to how close they are, basically. So, you know, Columbus is obviously in that list with like Nebraska and Oklahoma, schools that are kind of in my area, are schools I'm going to definitely go to first to check out, especially schools I haven't seen before, because there's only two schools in my top 10 that I've actually seen the campus. So just going to visit them and really get a good feel for them.
No doubt. That makes a ton of sense. And, you know, I think that will be really key for you as you look to narrow down from 10 to one eventually. A couple other things I want to talk about with Ohio State, I guess when you look at them as a program and as a place that could be your future home for anywhere from 3 to 5 years, what are the things that you like about the Buckeyes?
It was the culture that they have around there, the expectation of winning, coming in every day and working your hardest. It's just something that I love and something that, you know, I want to be pushed every day. And the type of players they bring in are real, you know, they're real family dudes. They're real all, you know, they're all nice dudes. They're all nice people there up there. And I know that just because I'm from Ohio. You know, I've seen the type of guys that work there and everything like that. So I'd say that's what stands out the most is kind of the, you know, the culture of the team.
Yeah, for sure. And, you know, you mentioned the guys they're bringing in. I know one player who we've been calling Captain Buckeye because since he's committed, he's just been all over social media, hitting you guys up, is CJ Hicks, another guy who is kind of defensive back, going to be a linebacker, hybrid type player. Talk a little bit about your relationship with CJ, what he's been telling you.
Me and CJ started talking back in May when I first got the offer around then. And, you know, me and him, we became real good friends ever since then. You know, me and him talk every day. You know, obviously, he likes to talk to me a lot about what me and him could do at Ohio State. You know, he thinks that me and him could be, you know, the best duo in college football. And, you know, just with that size and that athleticism we both bring on both sides would be something special. And just besides that, just staying in a lot of contact, you know, he's probably recruiting a lot more dudes than coaches are even doing right now. You know, he's trying to get everybody on board. So I love what he's trying to do. You know, it shows him how involved he really is, how much he really loves Ohio State. You know, he's just trying to spread that to everyone.
Yeah, for sure. And, you know, we got a chance to see him. I wasn't there, but my colleagues in Ohio were at the underclassmen report camp. And it was CJ and Sean Murphy, and he was giving Sean the same pitch. And, you know, I think a question we asked Sean was like, is it more attractive for you knowing that you could come to Ohio State with a guy like CJ next to you, potentially with a guy like Desaun McCullough next to you? So for you, you know, I know obviously Ohio State has CJ. I think they're in a pretty good spot with Sean. They're one of his top schools also. Like, have you thought about, like, you know, being able to play alongside those two guys or like guys like them with that much talent? Like, is that something that's attractive to you?
You know, that's probably one of the most attractive parts about it, actually. You know, just as a linebacker core, who are the other two or three linebackers you're playing with? And, you know, having a dude like CJ, who is almost just like me on the other side, you know, the only difference probably I'm just a little bit taller. And, you know, us both bringing that kind of coverage game, hitting, you know, we're both hard hitters, real good at man coverage type guys on both sides. And with Sean in the middle. You know, if you just look at it on paper, you know, it looks pretty ridiculous, honestly. So, yeah, it's definitely attractive to see. And, you know, with everything going on right now, you know, just seeing those guys compete at that camp was pretty big too. So, yeah, definitely.
Awesome. And, you know, we'll spend the last part of, you know, this podcast and video interview talking about your dad a little bit. First of all, his story – he like blew up in the public eye like a couple years ago when that story came out, which was like unbelievable, super cool. But for you, you know, obviously he's just your dad, and he's been a coach. He's been a college coach. Now he's an NFL coach with the Kansas City Chiefs. Before we dive into everything, I was at the Super Bowl. I'm sure you were too, I would imagine. How cool was that for you, your family, your dad, to see him be a part of the Chiefs winning the Super Bowl?
You know, it made us all real proud of my dad. You know, first of all, you know, seeing him get to that point, we've all seen how hard he's been working with all the places he's been at. And, you know, that's as big as it gets, is winning the Super Bowl, you know. So being there, having that experience, sharing that time with him, you know, is a once-in-a-lifetime thing. You know, hopefully with the Chiefs again, they do it again this year. So I don't know. It was real special, though. You know, that's kind of the only way to put it. All the days leading up to the game were all special, too. And after the game was definitely the biggest part to that celebration. So definitely.
Yeah, for sure. And, you know, it's having him as a dad, I'm sure he's a great dad, but having a dad who's also a coach, how has that helped you as a player, as a person, as a kid going through this recruiting process? Like, what has it been like to have him as a resource?
You know, it's been huge, honestly. You know, he helps me with the recruiting process a lot. You know, he's not like demanding or anything like that. You know, he just leads me towards the right way and kind of, you know, tells me the truth about schools, you know, that what he's heard, you know, because he's been around it all. He's been around all those coaches, so everything like that. Then he kind of just tells me the truth on myself. You know, he tells me how I need, if I need to work harder to really be like a pro, you know, because he sees how pros work. So it's kind of just like telling me, oh, you need to step this up, or, you know, I could watch NFL tape with him, and it's kind of just like an advantage to have over everyone else, just having somebody like that to always be in your ear and kind of reminding you and everything like that. It's huge.
Yeah. As I was going to say, like, has he taken you around? I mean, I'm sure when you were younger, you were obviously around the college programs a lot, but have you gotten a chance to like go around, you know, the Chiefs facility, spend time with those guys, pick up anything from them?
Yeah, definitely. Tyrann Mathieu's probably the biggest part of that. Me and him have had a couple good, great conversations, you know, just about football in general, and kind of picking his brain just to see the mental part, you know, because that's kind of how he separates himself, how smart he is. So that's just kind of the biggest part he was talking to me about, was kind of the mental part of the game and your IQ. So that's definitely something I've picked his brain from. Obviously, I've thrown the ball around a couple times with Mahomes and Kelsey, and, you know, just kind of seeing how they work in person, that type of work ethic, you know, it's real contagious, you know, makes everybody around you want to work harder and everything. So I've definitely picked up a couple things from those guys.
What are your strengths on the field and off the field as a leader? And what are the things you think you need to work on before you get to college?
You know, I feel like I'll start with my weaknesses. I feel like my weaknesses would kind of be anything normal for a junior, you know, just becoming more mature with the game, you know, kind of getting a better feel for it. You know, that's just kind of everything I want to work on. As in for my strengths, I feel like my IQ is what separates me at my age. I feel like there's not a lot of players in the country that understand the game the way I do and look at it the same way. So I feel like my IQ really separates myself. I feel like I'm a great leader for my team right now. I know everybody's position and what they're supposed to be doing. I'm gonna get on your head just to make sure that you're staying focused. You know that everybody's running everything perfect, because that's the only thing that we accept is excellence. So, you know, that's the standard that we're all held to, and I'm gonna hold everybody to also. So it's me being a leader. It's my IQ of the game. And I feel like it's how physical I am too. You know, obviously I play some free safety too, but when I step into the box, I'm as physical as a DN. So it's kind of like that, just being versatile like that and really helping my team out in as many ways as possible.
Awesome, man. And last question, we're going to take it away from football for a second. We know especially your family, it's football a lot of the time, but tell us a little bit about the Sam McCullough. What do you like to do when you're not on the football field?
Off the field, I kind of just do anything, you know, a normal kid would do. I like to play basketball a lot. I used to do that a lot. I used to do that competitively a lot. I used to be almost my main sport just about. But I just play it for fun now with my friends, hang out with them. I play Xbox a lot. I probably say that's the main thing I do. I'm either doing that or I'm with my girlfriend, you know, something like that, just with my friends. So, you know, pretty average things, nothing out of the ordinary.
Cool, man. Well, you know, we appreciate you joining. Congrats again, 42 offers and counting. That's incredible. You know, obviously those listening to the show, Ohio State fans, hoping you end up playing in Columbus, but we wish you the best of luck this upcoming season and no matter where your journey takes you.
Thank you.
This episode of Around the Oval was brought to you by Todd Pennington with Revolution Mortgage. If you've been thinking about refinancing or buying a house, check out our sponsor, Todd Pennington with Revolution Mortgage. They offer low rates for refinancing and home purchase loans, including first-time home buyer programs, down payment assistance, and cash-out home equity loans. Check out revolutionmortgage.com/tpennington.